SASH stands for Saline, Administer Medicine, Saline, and Heparin. It reminds us of the order for flushing an IV catheter during medicine administration. Before flushing the IV catheter, check the pharmacy label on the bag of saline and heparin syringes to make sure all of the information on the labels are correct. Check the label on the medicine syringe, Eclipse device, or infusion bag you'll be administering. Verify all information on the label is correct. To prepare for flushing the IV catheter, first, wash your hands. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Then, lay down a clean paper drape or towel to create a safe zone. On your paper drape, place two pre-filled saline flush syringes, one pre-filled heparin flush syringe, the medicine device or infusion bag you'll be giving, and four chlorhexidine swabs. To prepare your flush syringes, remove the plastic package around the pre-filled saline flush syringe and then remove the cap. Lay the cap on the safe zone with the opened end toward the ceiling. Do not touch the opened end of the cap or the tip of the syringe. Then push up gently to push any air out of the syringe. You may tap the syringe to move air bubbles to the top if needed. Carefully pick up the cap without touching the open end and put it onto the sterile tip of the syringe. Repeat these steps with the other saline flush syringe and the heparin flush syringe. You do not need to prepare the medicine syringe. It has been prepared by the pharmacy. Open the clamp on your child's IV catheter if the catheter has a clamp. Open the first chlorhexidine swab. Use the swab to scrub the hub of the needleless connector for 15 to 30 seconds. Let the hub air dry. Do not fan or blow on the hub to speed up the drying. Attach a saline flush syringe to the hub of the needleless connector. Use the push-pause technique to slowly push the fluid from the saline syringe into the IV catheter. Hold on to the needleless connector and remove the empty syringe from the hub of the connector. Put the empty syringe into the trash. Be sure you do not remove the connector from the end of the IV catheter while you are removing the syringe. Open a new chlorhexidine swab and scrub the hub of the needleless connector for 15 to 30 seconds. Let the hub air dry. Attach a pre-filled medicine syringe to the needleless connector. If you are using an Eclipse device or an IV bag to give an infusion, you would attach the IV tubing to the needleless connector. Slowly push the medicine syringe plunger to give the medicine over the recommended amount of time. When the medicine has been given, hold on to the needleless connector and remove the medicine syringe. Put the empty syringe into the trash. Open a chlorhexidine swab and scrub the hub of the needleless connector for 15 to 30 seconds. Let the hub air dry. Attach the second saline flush syringe to the hub of the needleless connector. Use the push-pause technique to slowly push the fluid from the syringe into the IV catheter. Hold on to the needleless connector and remove the empty syringe from the hub of the connector. Put the empty syringe into the trash. Repeat these steps with the heparin flush syringe. Scrub the hub with a chlorhexidine swab. Attach the syringe. And use the push-pause technique to push the heparin into the IV catheter. Before you remove the heparin syringe, close the clamp on your child's IV catheter if the catheter has a clamp. Hold on to the needleless connector and remove the empty heparin syringe from the hub of the connector. Put the empty syringe into the trash. Here are a couple of points to remember when flushing an IV catheter. Never use force when flushing an IV catheter. The syringe plunger should move smoothly and easily. If you find it difficult to push the syringe plunger, first, check to be sure the clamp on the IV catheter is open. If the clamp is open and it's still difficult to flush the catheter, call your IV nurse. If the patient has swelling, burning, or pain during flushing, stop and call your IV nurse.